So welcome to Thought for the Week. Today we'll be looking at the brave Queen Esther saving the Jewish people. And so we'll sing and listen to our first hymn, All My Hope on God is Founded, Songs of Fellowship 455. The time when the Jewish people living in Persia were saved from extermination by the courage of a young Jewish woman called Esther. It's customary to hold carnival-like celebrations on Purim, to perform plays and parodies and to hold beauty contests. Purim is not subject to the restrictions on work that affect some other holidays. However, some sources indicate that Jews should not go about their ordinary business at Purim out of respect for the festival. The main commandment related to Purim is to hear the reading of the Book of Esther. It's read in the synagogue and it's read on the eve of Purim and on Purim itself. At Purim, Jews read the story of Esther in the synagogue and it's usually entertaining with a rowdy company. The synagogue is crowded with men, women and children. Some wear their best Sunday clothes, Sabbath clothes, and some just dress up in colourful costumes and masks. The Purim story features a villain called Haman, and everybody in the synagogue boos and hisses and stamps their feet and uses noisemakers whenever the name of Haman is mentioned during the service. The purpose of the custom is to blot out the name of Haman, because he was a villain. So, children really enjoy dressing up as the characters found in the Book of Esther, including the king, Queen Esther, Mordecai and Haman. It's a sort of a mitzvah where Jewish people should eat, drink and be merry at Purim. In addition, Jews are expected to send gifts of money, food or drink and make donations to charity. So it's a common treat at this time of year for Haman's pockets, sometimes called hematash, and these are sort of triangular shaped, like the triangular hat that he used to wear. So the story of Purim. The story of Purim is told in the book of Esther, and so we won't be reading the scripture because it's very lengthy, so we'll just have the synopsis of it. Esther is a Jewish girl who becomes queen to King of Persia, and through her bravery is able to stop an attempt to slaughter all the Jews living in Persia at that time. Purim commemorates Esther's courage in saving the Jewish people living in Persia 2,000 years ago from extermination. The heroes are Esther and her cousin Mordecai. Esther had no mother or father, and Mordecai brought her up as if she was his daughter. The villain of the story is Haman, the favourite nobleman. The king can be seen as a villain because in some ways he treats women because of his unwillingness to accept that they are valuable. And he has all the Jews, and he would have all the Jews to be killed for no reason. The king summoned beautiful virgins from all over the land to find a new queen. And after seeing many women, he chose Esther. The king chose her without knowing that Esther was a Jew, because Mordecai had told her not to tell him who she was and of what faith she was. Haman was furious with Mordecai because Mordecai refused to bow down before him to show his respect. So to punish Mordecai, Haman decided to exterminate the whole Jewish people. So Haman went to the king and told him what he thought he ought to do to get rid of the Jews. So Mordecai persuaded Esther to beg the king for mercy for the Jews, pointing out the reason she had become queen was so that she could rescue the Jews. Going to see the king was risky for Esther, because if you approached the king without being summoned, you could be in danger. But the king hadn't sent for Esther for a month. Esther fasted for 3 days to prepare herself, as did all the Jews in her town, and then went to see the king. Fortunately, he was very pleased to see her. He welcomed her, and she eventually told him of Haman's plan to exterminate the Jews. She begged the king to show mercy to the Jewish people, and the king granted it at once, and the Jewish people were saved. So what does that teach us about Esther? God endures that and makes sure that the good wins over the bad. God is always there, even when we don't see him, when he's unseen. And this interpretation comes from the fact that God is never mentioned in the book of Esther, but he certainly is there in the faith, trust and loyalty of the Jews. And God plans ahead. God makes Esther queen in order to provide the way in which the Jews will be saved from death. Even though the events which we know about today, the Jews had never even known that anything like that was going to happen. And so our faith in God is just an extension of Esther's faith in her God too. So let us pray. Loving God, bring your light and reassuring presence to the dark places in our lives. Bring your hope to hearts that feel defeated. Bring your love and compassion to those in pain. As we go through each day, bring the truth of your word to our minds and help us to apply your wisdom to our smallest decisions. Amen. And so we sing our closing hymn, which is also our blessing. Go peaceful.
Go peaceful in gentleness through the violence of these days. Give freely, show tenderness in all your ways. Through darkness, in troubled times, let holiness be your aim. Seek wisdom, let faithfulness burn like a flame. God speed you, God lead you, and keep you wrapped around his heart. May you be known by love. Be righteous, speak truthfully, in a world of greed and lies.